Welcome to State of the Galaxies, 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 Galaxies. I see Sidious. I see Hugged. I see Zazkag. I see the Galaga King, the King of Galaga. Or is it Galaga? You tell me. I'm looking at Skype. No one has Skyped in. So that's all I have to say about that. And Decidius is at work, so he'll be in and out. This won't be a particularly long State of the Galaxies. Holy smokes! A-E-I-O, all vowels. I remember when I I-U-E, I just want to say all vowels. What's up? The glasses. Here's the thing. It might look like I'm wearing glasses, but I'm really not. It's just my elite gameplay skills are starting to take visible shape on me. And so it kind of looks like, you might see me with a Nintendo Power Glove at some point, it just appears on my hand. I posted a question on the States of the Galaxies. Yes, I saw it. I'm going to answer that question. What's up, Max? 00110011100. Before I go into the State of the Galaxies, I'm just going to wait a minute. Just let people gather so they don't miss anything. We have been a bad community. Get ready to wag your finger. Listen. I am more like I'm an enforcer, not a, I don't judge the community. I shan't do that. I will enforce the law with as much objectivity as humanly possible. I think the community is always going to move through cycles as it grows and expands. As more things come into play, you got to realize Twin Galaxies has more functionality and options than it ever did before in the past. And that just, so there's a lot of new ground, new discoveries, new ways to figure out what the groove is going to be. Just a thought, how about limiting the privileges of members to opening a tribunal once per every 6 months? No. I think the only limitation so far is that you need to be verified and you need to have a minimum credibility rating, which demonstrates an interest in participating at Twin Galaxies. And it weeds out the ability for newcomers to come in, get verified, cause problems, create tribunals on their own, and for the sole purpose of disrupting the community. But I'm trying really hard to let the community have as much. Don Atreides, is our volume really low? Neo, do you know? Okay, maybe I'm talking low. I could talk louder. Well, The King of Galaga, or Galaga, endless debate there on that one, says the sound's okay, so I can speak up. But basically what I was saying was the community, my personal philosophy is to try to empower the community as much as possible and not take things away from it. I'm not a big believer in taking things away from people in order to prevent them from hurting themselves or doing something. Now, obviously, sometimes that has to take place, but I don't think, you know, there's two approaches to solving something where you can either prevent someone from doing it in the first place, or you can allow them to do it, but teach them why it's not a good idea to do it, so they can make a decision. One is a lot easier to do than the other. And I think a lot of frustration that people have with the way that we administrate Twin Galaxies is that we do not take the quicker route. We let things sort of take shape so that people can, and so it that can be frustrating for some sometimes. All right, so I think we've got at least some gathering of at least two people. So as long as there's at least two people, we can proceed. And by the way, I'm wearing these glasses just for fun, not because I think I'm extra cool. Just for fun. Okay, so let's move on. So the Right to Game campaign. We are moments away. How far away, Neo, are we from sending out bracelets and stuff? Yeah, like next business day, like physical stuff's gonna start to go out to people, and then that will be it. So just if you've been waiting on one of the hoodies or the bracelets or the keychain or some of those physical items, we just got the whole thing in from 86th, so out it goes. So that's the update so far. And I'm going to move to the next slide. Yes, Decidius, everybody needs to, I don't know what it is about the community, but it's just very hard for it to calm down and relax. Just relax a little bit. It's okay. People aren't going to die. Every problem is solvable, and we will solve it. Over time, it's not going to, we'll get, it's just, you know, I think what it is, as just as video game players, I include myself in that, we can be very impatient and we like immediacy. So that's just going to come out in our personalities. And, you know, in my mind, for me, I just understand that. That's why when there's all these flare-ups and, I mean, obviously I'm constantly attacked. I'm not like getting angry about it or wanting to attack back because I understand it's like the nature of us to just get into it, man. How can you expect someone who has the discipline to sit in front of a Donkey Kong machine for 4 hours trying to get this a super high score? Think of the personality characteristics you have to be able to do that, and then just think, oh well, you know, everything else. It's like. We can be very intense people. So that's okay. I don't think there's nothing wrong with that. What I try to do is, you know, try to help people so we don't all get worked up together, because you can see if you look at Twin Galaxies Pass what happens when the entire group gets worked up into a whirlwind of whirlwindness. It's just a little calm. Have I ever broken a joystick or keyboard before? Yeah, especially back in the day, not a keyboard, but man, I used to have a Commodore 128, and I had a Kraft joystick. I don't know if you ever had one of those, but they, you know, diagonal movements are really hard on Atari joysticks. Commodore uses Atari joystick input, so you could use an Atari joystick, but man, diagonals in a lot of Commodore 64 games, man, really needed those diagonals to be perfect. So I got a Kraft joystick, which had like a little thin stick, but man, it was so precise, but I'd snap those things constantly. I broke an HDTV 5 months ago. Yeah, see, this is, I have seen recent claims that I am from Hollywood, that I'm like a Hollywood person, which is interesting to me because I'm not from Hollywood. That's not where my career comes from. My career comes from video games. My first professional job in the video game business was at a company called Broderbund Software. You might know them. They made Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego, Karateka, all that stuff. I worked there. That's where my career comes from, not Hollywood. Hollywood is like, I didn't get down here into the Hollywood universe until like 2004. So I had already gone deep, you know, 13 or 15 years into just professional video game making well before that. Anyway, I digress. My whole point was, is that I think everything about video game culture, what we are, how we are, it's just like it's cool and it's valid and it's just the way we do things. And that's all right. And that's to me, that's how we are. There's, you know, you can say there's good things about it and there's bad things about it, but it's how we all collectively are together. And I've lived that way. So I don't really get all bent out of shape when the community seems to get so feisty with itself. I understand it. I just wish the community would understand itself as well and allow itself breathing room to be. We should allow each other to have a little bit of latitude and not get so... There's Knitting PC. What's up? All right, so let me keep going. Boom. Oh, yeah, so recent administration stuff. There's been some credibility requirements for the ability to create tribunals. And there has been some discussion of banning, which tribunals in themselves are unpleasant, negative things in general. I would prefer the community try to avoid issuing them because it's just never a good thing. I really think that it's better to try to talk it out. Some cases, I've seen the community try to talk it out. In other cases, it's not so much. But again, I want to be clear about the credibility requirement, the CR requirement. If before, all you had to be was a verified user, and you would have you had the authority to call a tribunal up. It doesn't mean it would go through, it doesn't mean you'd win, but you could do it. So, somebody new could come into Twin Galaxies, get verified, cause a ruckus if they wanted to, and call a tribunal up at all in the same time. And eventually, yes, a system would weed them out, but it would just, if the goal was to get on to Twin Galaxies and cause community disruption for the sake of it, the tribunal function was one more thing, a tool that could be used to create disruption. So we decided that by having a minimum credibility rating to be able to bring up a tribunal will gate that abuse potentiality. So by setting it at 2000, which really to get to a 2000 CR, you've got to adjudicate a fair amount. And when you adjudicate, you wind up participating in various threads on those adjudications. Sometimes you just vote, but every now and then you might comment and interact with the community. So you're showing an investment. And so then it starts to make sense that someone who's spending all this time adjudicating should be able to bring up a social tribunal because they're participating socially and they're trying to make the environment conducive for everybody. So that's where that came from. And some people like it, some people don't. My official answer is that one's not up for debate. I on a certain level, I have to make some choices, put some groundwork in, and I've explained my logic. You can not like it, but that's how it is for now. And we will see how it goes, okay? I'm not an unreasonable human being that, you know, said 20 years ago, this is how it is, and then won't change it for 20 years. It's not that. But for right now, let's see how that goes. It seems to be doing well. Also, after witnessing the Backsaber Tribunal and the Creech Tribunal, I have decided that allowing whoever is on tribunal to defend themselves and participate in the tribunal, it's not conducive to the thread staying on topic. It tends to derail the thread. So for the foreseeable future, it's just not going to be allowed. It's only been allowed twice, in the Backstabber one and then in this one involving Creech. All prior tribunals, it was never allowed. And so that's just how it's going to have to stay. Decidius is leaving. People need to get drunk. Have a good night. All right, see you, Decidius. All right. So in any case, I think all the tribunals are over and nothing's going on in that area anymore. So hopefully we'll be able to keep it that way and we can all get along. That's what I would hope. Let's move on. Okay, as you noticed, the notification system has been enhanced with more messaging, whether, you know, an adjudication is completed, whether you scored points for the right voting, all that stuff. And this is what I was kind of talking about, is when we added that system in, it wound up breaking other parts of Twin Galaxies. So then you start seeing all these thread posts of, oh, the submission points aren't adding up, this isn't working, there's submissions that are being accepted but they're staying open. All like the system inside of Twin Galaxies is much more complicated than it looks like on the surface. So we wind up having to debug. Now I believe the engineers told me that they have fixed all of the issues as of today, and that CR and submission points and all that other stuff is being calculated correctly. I did see a post from Timmel asking about his PSI, and I know the engineers are looking at his PSI is reading as 7 for a particular category, and it should be 16 potentially. And I know they're looking into that, and we'll see why that is. Basically, what can happen with PSI is, there's services that run in the background that are looking at all the leaderboards, and then has to look at everybody's score, and it has to do all the comparisons and everything, and it basically has to traverse all of the different tiering, you know. So you've got the game, and then you've got the different leaderboards under each game. Sometimes, as it's trying to traverse, it'll time out. When it times out, it doesn't pick up where it left off, and so some things don't get calculated in. So, and really, the vast majority of those problems just stem from when we initially change a calculation, because it has to go through absolutely everything and recalculate. Once everything's been totally recalculated perfectly, then as new scores come in, it only has to recalculate around that particular score that comes in. So the load on the system isn't as heavy, and it doesn't miss anything, and it can't time out. So what you're probably seeing is some after effects of some derivative part of the service that didn't finish. And so all we have to do is restart up that service, and it will calculate it correct. East Ender. We're talking about Twin Galaxies. This is the state of the galaxy. So I'll bring you up to speed. TwinGalaxies.com has, it's a place for the world's best video game players to congregate and show and prove what they do and have their performance evaluated and registered. It can bubble up to the Guinness Book of World Records. And it's all of competitive video gaming, not just the sort of popular esports that you might hear about, like League of Legends or Dota or Heroes of the Storm or whatever. They're, you know, those very high profile esports are only a sliver of the video game playing that takes place in the world. And so Twin Galaxies actually looks at the entire spectrum, from mobile phone to past historic platforms, all the way up to, you know, recent titles like H1Z1, which is still even in beta. So there's a community there. There are players that achieve things, and essentially Twin Galaxies logs and shows what those achievements are on an individual basis, kind of like the IMDb does for movie actors or writers. And so that way, all of those achievements can be preserved, and the video game player can actually leverage them for opportunities for themselves. like getting sponsors or whatever. And that way they're not reliant on a single game. So Twin Galaxies is that place, and State of the Galaxies is where we talk about community issues, ways to improve the system, you know, just sort of stay connected as a growing group. So it's not, well, Paragon is, the difference with Twin Galaxies and something like Paragon is everything that's going into Twin Galaxies' system has been verified and checked. It's not just taking anything from anywhere and listing it out, because who knows how valid those things can be. Twin Galaxies is actually processing all of those things, verifying that cheating hasn't taken place. And then once it's passed through the system, then it gets logged into a player's profile, and that's it. So it's sort of an exclusive club that's growing, because if you as you want to build a career in playing video games and get paid for it, it's very important that you are not stuck on just only one game for the rest of your life. And that's the only way that you can earn money, because if that video game falls out of popularity, what happens to your career? That's a real challenge. However, so if all you ever are is, say, a great League of Legends player, your career is as long as League of Legends lasts, right? But if you become a great video game player, and then suddenly we look at everything you've done over your lifespan as a video game player, well, that shifts it. That changes the nature of the conversation. And so Twin Galaxies is there to help facilitate that conversation, to help build more communities. Hello, Scarlet Speedster. And so you sort of have stumbled into the broadcast that talks to the community about those issues. And, you know, Twin Galaxies has been around for 30 years. There's been many movies made about it. And you'll see Twin Galaxies continue to rise and become more and more integrated into gaming as you see it today, not only historic gaming, but current gaming as well. So anyway, notification system, that went up. We've been fixing bugs. Hopefully you like all the additional notifications, and it's hopefully creating more activity and making it more fun to be on the site, because you're not missing anything. So let me move on. Okay, I'm gonna kind of, these are some of the State of the Galaxies questions that came in. This one is, hey, as you know, the last 2 weeks have been more than usual drama, both the tribunal as well as criticism of my hands-off approach have been much talked about. I think some of the confusion comes from some of the admins having more hands approach than me, than you. It's tough for people to know what the community is responsible for, and when you have admins doing some things, and then, you know, and then you not doing things. We've even had administration cancel the tribunal because they weren't sure if enough people would support it. I'm sure you can understand that when people have their tribunals canceled or comments edited, they're kind of shocked when they hear me say that I don't want to get involved. So the sum question here is, you know, there'll be continue to be arguments and calls for me to be involved. As long as confusion remains over what we are and aren't responsible for, can I provide clarification to not just the community, but also to the admins on when the staff will get involved? Did anyone mention notifications screwing up? I got 5 notifications. We fixed the system today, so the system could be going through and purging stuff and doing stuff. Just give it 24 hours. Okay, anyway, I know that we as a community really like rules and structure. And this question is rooted in rules and structure and order. But you got to understand that when you're dealing with a social environment of a community, there has to be just having clear, unabridged, unchanging rules that's governing behavior Yes, you can do that for the fundamentals, of course. But when you get into these nuanced communications between people, periodically there has to be something that's sort of looking at that and making a judgment about what might work and what might not work. As a general rule, Twin Galaxies admin is directed to keep a hands-off approach as much as possible. There will be times where a determination is made where it just, where intervention just needs to take place. And so I can't tell you specifically what those conditions are, because we have such a dynamic range of people and circumstances that take place on Twin Galaxies. There's no way to create a perfect map for that. The only thing that you can count on is that the approach, whenever there is an intervention, will A, have an explanation attached to it as to why there was an intervention, and that there will be some form of objective logic applied to the intervention. You may not agree with it, but it will not, it definitely is not going to be emotionally based. Whatever the interference will be, it's not because of someone at Twin Galaxies being mad or upset or anything like that. But you know, for the most part, the community has been doing a good job keeping itself socially organized. I mean, I don't think you understand. A, you know, people underestimate how much activity is taking place on Twin Galaxies. It's more than you think. It's just more than you think. People keep thinking it's like small. Twin Galaxies right now is like bigger than it ever was, both in terms of the user base. You know, unlike many other communities, I mean, there are, for those of, I don't know how many of you are in all these other gaming communities, but hold on a sec. What are you guys doing over there? A lot of gaming communities are super toxic. I'm talking super, super toxic. If you go, I mean, I have to spend a lot of time in the League of Legends community. There is a lot of toxicity. So on a comparative analysis, Twin Galaxies is very mild. Donna Trady says, what about Neostorm adjudicating records? Neostorm is the technical, he's the head of technical operations over at Twin Galaxies Live. Neostorm has nothing to do with TwinGalaxies.com. He has no access to it beyond just being a regular verified member, which I'm assuming he just did the normal verification process. But just like Nick, who's standing here in the Twin Galaxies t-shirt that just came in. You were a member of TwinGalaxies.com before you worked for Twin Galaxies Live. See, so Neostorm, you have to understand the structure of Twin Galaxies. TwinGalaxies.com, people like myself or Franny or like the engineers and the rest of the group, they can't adjudicate. They can't intervene. People who, you know, who are on broadcast or there's a show that's going on here, they don't have anything to do with the adjudication of Twin Galaxies. They don't have access. They can't see anything. They don't even know where it is. They don't even know. So, in answer to your question, Don, that is why Neostorm is able to adjudicate records. Neostorm is actually a employee for HD Films, not. Twin Galaxies as a business entity. So, what's wrong with toxic? If people didn't want it, they just wouldn't play. They must be okay with it being toxic. You know, the video game communities, they can just be rough with each other. I mean, look, I'm old and crusty, and I have seen this since the beginning, since standing in an arcade, okay? It's competitive environments, man. People get that way. Now, our society has evolved to be like a little more sensitive than it has been in the past, and so toxicity has become a catchphrase. But I could arguably say that Twin Galaxies community is actually quite mature relative to the vast majority of the video game communities that I see and participate in. So there's this constant, I think people in Twin Galaxies are always so harsh on themselves. Like, oh man, our community this and our community, dude, you guys are not that bad. So, okay, Don has another question. What about the H1Z1 adjudication intervention? TG staff told people what evidence was acceptable, which contradicts the idea that the community determines what gets accepted. That's actually not completely accurate. So Twin Galaxies has a set of rules and policies that are in the help section that sets the baseline for the determination of how things are adjudicated and get accepted. The adjudication process, the TGSAP process, is the process where the community is able to evaluate something against the stated rules. So there's a system, right? Where you have, here are the stated rules. Now, based on what you're seeing here, community, you're authorized to evaluate based on what you're seeing here, okay? But the superstructure that these rules and this system lives within is based within the Twin Galaxies policies and procedures, which date back 30 years and have evolved over time. In the case of H1Z1, it was literally a type of video game that Twin Galaxies had never in its entire history adjudicated or processed. So it had no policy in relating or corresponding game to even look at as to how to handle a persistent state, massively multiplayer online game. So when the first rule set was posted, it was very thin because there was nothing, it relied on the idea that there had been a historical adjudication in the area, in that subject area. But then as adjudicators came in, they immediately had questions. Where is this? Where is that? They're trying to adjudicate a certain game type against a different game type's baseline. And that's when it became clear that an intervention had to take place and the full scope of the rules needed to be elaborated and incorporated into the actual nature of this type of game. Because without having any kind of intervention, there would have been no way to properly adjudicate. There would have been no guidance to adjudicate that. And Twin Galaxies needs to provide that guidance when it can. The question was whether PC boot up was required. TG has been adjudicating PC games for 20 years. Whether or not TG has been adjudicating PC games for 20 years isn't relative to why a PC boot up is required. A PC boot up is required in order to demonstrate that the environment that you're playing in is not manipulated. That's the way to do it. And in order to adjudicate the MMO, where the game itself is not running on the PC, you have to understand, when you're in all of other Twin Galaxies PC games, the game itself is running on the PC. You're showing the boot up of the game. In the case of H1Z1, you're not showing the boot up of the game. The game is already running on the Daybreak servers, and there's no way for a player to go to Daybreak and boot up the server for people to see that. That's the only place where the actual game manipulation can take place. Everything else is client manipulation. And that's easily seen in the video. Because all client manipulation can do is alter the visuals. It can't manipulate the game server. So that had to be specified and delineated out so that the adjudicating community could understand that difference. Because it really doesn't matter go ahead, do whatever you want on your client side of the machine. You can't change the server side. It's just, there's nothing you can do. So there are entire methods of cheating that simply cannot take place in that kind of environment. And so as Twin Galaxies starts to adjudicate more and more of these kinds of things, that experience pool will rise and grow. And I won't have to explain as much, and more precedent will be set. And that's why. Here's the rub, Don says. Why technical interference in that thread and complete hands-off in the RU MAME thread? Well, I'm not sure which RU MAME thread you're referring to. There's one RU MAME thread where there's a discussion about whether or not Twin Galaxies should accept RU scores. And I know I've typed in that thread to ask questions and see what's going on. The only other thing I can think of is, are you referring to the Donkey Kong submission? There's no, in the Donkey Kong submission where someone submitted a RU MAME track to a Wolfmane specified track, there's nothing to interfere with. I don't know where there would be a need to interfere with that. That's a very direct adjudication. Here are the rules for that track. Here is something that comes in for that track. You as a community can decide whether or not it's following the rules for that track. We were told we were looking like children to our... Well, if there was a user who wrote that you were looking like children in that thread, it wasn't me. So you'd have to ask the user who wrote that. I don't know. I don't know how to answer that question. So if you can be more clear, I'll happily answer it. AUE, off topic. When I lived in Chicago, one of the local arcades, a person took out a knife after telling someone to stop throwing me, or else, dude, I'm not surprised. Username Jace Hall, I'll find it for you. No, I would remember writing that in that thread, Don. I don't think that I wrote that in that thread. I do remember a user in that thread writing something about that. But I didn't call anybody any names. Let's see, I have a question. Is there a criteria to be selected for a blog highlight? No, not really. It's basically random, and I'm going to be talking about the blogs in a minute. Wes Copeland, God forbid I state my opinion in that thread. The first response was one saying I should be banned for life. Then the DK hatred flowed. It wouldn't be getting this much attention if it wasn't DK. Look. The issue that I saw in that particular thread was that you had a submission on a Wolfmame track that wasn't using Wolfmame. And so there were people who recognized that and were rejecting based on that. And I think, Wes, when you came in, because you are the number one world record Donkey Kong holder, and just with that, and with your long history in the community, when you said that this is something that should be accepted in the thread, I think that created the point of contention. Because really what you and some others were saying is that this score should be accepted at Twin Galaxies, because it's a legitimate score, okay? So let's take for granted that the score is legitimate. The issue was, should that score be accepted on that track, which was for Wolfmane? And so this whole sort of conversation took place inside of this thread, when really there were two things that were going on. One was a general conversation about whether a retro uprising Donkey Kong score is legitimate, and is that score legitimate, right? And people are saying it is legitimate, so Twin Galaxies should take it. And then the other conversation is, this track is for Wolfmane. This is not a Wolfmane track. Why are we being told that we should accept this? And that sort of taking place. Certainly, it can be argued that sometimes a community can collectively behave like children. If that is in the thread that you're talking about, then that has to be below the posting where someone has posted that people are acting like children and calling for parents, because that is what it's referring to. It's referencing the statement that the previous users had made. So hopefully that does that make sense to you, Don? Wes says, I'm completely fine with that conversation happening. What I'm not fine with is all of the ad hominem that happened and people using it as an opportunity to... Okay, Wes, but here's the thing. This is where I was just getting back to in the beginning. Everybody needs to just relax. First of all, as video game people, we're just going to be feisty. So that there's a certain amount of feist that's just going to take place. And I think that's okay, right? There's always going to be ad hominem. Always. There's just always that. Like here, No. I'm not saying, what I'm saying is if you read, Don, if you read the thread up above where I posted, a user posts and complains that there are people acting like children and calling for their parents. That is in the thread above what I post. So when I'm talking, I'm referring to the entire scope of the conversation in the thread. So that's, hopefully that makes sense to you. That's what I was doing. So Wes, listen, you are a human being just like everybody else in the forums, and I've seen frustration fly everywhere. So I have no doubt that it was frustrating to see, you know, the Donkey Kong community get attacked, you know. But to me, it's just like, it's all right, man. It's okay. Like it doesn't change the fact that you're kick ass in Donkey Kong, and Donkey Kong's an important game, and there's other games that are important, and all that is okay. I think it's wrong to try to create a situation where people are afraid to speak. And because, you know, I just think it's all right. Let, you know, you put yourself out there, we put ourselves out there, we all put ourselves out there. And then we just need to have a little bit of a latitude. I think it's okay. I understand. I can see the frustration in the whole thread, right? But I didn't personally think that thread needed any intervention. I honestly believed that the Twin Galaxies community will look at the rules, look at what was submitted, and make a judgment based on what they think. And I think that's exactly what happened. There was no reason at all for me to intervene in that, unlike the H1Z1 thread, which needed an intervention, which goes back to, I think, Don's original question. Question is off top, but what are my thoughts on the whole recent competitive gaming gamers taking Adderall to do better in competitions? They don't have a prescription, nor they have a reason to be taking due to health problems. It's professional sport. Is it the same? I don't know if it's the same as professional sports athletes using HGH, but I would say I am generally against the use of drugs. in general. I am heavily involved with, you know, some of the League of Legends stuff. And the last thing that these players need to be doing, their diet already is crap. The last thing they need to be doing is taking drugs to be more alert and stay, you know, okay. They'll have a Red Bull or something like that, right? But, yeah, man, when you start moving in the prescription medications, I just don't think that's good for gaming. I don't think that's good for players. I wouldn't support it. It's just, you have to, on some level, but see, here's the other thing, which is, there's really, other than Twin Galaxies, which it doesn't have enough power today, there's not anything that would actually be looking at or thinking about the health of all the players in competitive gaming. You know? See you later there, Data God. It's like, who's looking out for the players? Companies are trying to sell their products, right? Riot wants to sell copies of League of Legends, for example. Good for them, that's their job. There's no one looking out. So Twin Galaxies really, it's gonna take time, effort, money, and growth, but that's, you know, what's gonna have to, who else is gonna do it? I'm afraid for that day when that kid, you know, is found dead in front of his computer because he's been playing Dota 2, cranked up on Adderall. Let's see, Don Atreides says, my point is the same as Snowflake's. TG appears to be inconsistent when it decides to intervene. Imagine trying to have a consistent drama-free community when you have a person or people that seem arbitrarily to change the rules. Well, the only way I can respond to that is the social landscape of Twin Galaxies and what takes place inside of it is not consistent. The things that occur can be very highly specific, and they have to be dealt with on a case-by-case basis. The only way that you can get around that is if you run things the way the military does, right? They have very hard and fast rules, and nothing really can move between them easily. But, you know, Twin Galaxies is, you know, the social aspect of the military is hardly the military's concern. They're there to keep the country safe, make war when necessary, and they've got lives are on the line. That's a different thing. Twin Galaxies is this dynamic thing. So if you don't have a person or people going in there and trying to address these new kinds of situations that have not occurred before, then what you'll actually have is a slow deconstruction of the community. It'll just start to come apart. So I'm not sure if the expectation is that, like a perfect example is the submission of an RU score into the Twin Galaxies system. That is a social occurrence. It's like a score slash social occurrence, right? In the old days of Twin Galaxies, that couldn't even have occurred because they would have sent in a videotape and they would have said, I used Retro Uprising, and the referee would have been like, that's great, and just sent it right back. There was no capacity for even for anything to take place in that way. So now you're going to have this constant set of new emergent behavior. And so, okay, so you're saying, I realize there has to be a balance, but flexi rules make drama. Once it was determined that Wolfmane was explicitly in the rule, the DK thread died down quick. Okay, but Don, here's the thing. The Wolfmane was always explicitly in the rules. That had never changed. There were no flexi nothing when it comes to that thread. All of that was laid out and available on Twin Galaxies the entire time. So intervention on that wasn't even required. Now, what I saw was a desire, a partial community desire for Retro Uprising scores to be accepted. And in the absence of any mechanism to get a Retro Uprising score in, someone just put it into the Wolfmane one because that's logically the only place it remotely could go. And then that brings up the whole conversation in that way. I would have preferred that submitter to have just posted into the forums and said, hey, I want to submit this. How do I get this in there? Don, firm rules, unfortunately, I have learned, does not equal no drama. Firm rules simply means different kinds of drama. Here's a perfect example. We had someone go up on tribunal, and there's a firm rule of a credibility of 2,000 to participate. That's a firm rule. All that did was create drama about that firm rule. There was no debate or question about it. It just created a whole different set of things to talk about and get heated as it related to that. So while I agree that it's always important to have as much stability and consistency as possible, I 100% agree with that. There's a reality that we're dealing with this living community organism, and that if you don't have the ability to flex and adapt to this thing, it will, well, a good example is the speedrun community, right? In the past, Twin Galaxies did not have the ability to adapt or didn't have the willingness to adapt and flex to a new set of gamers with a different set of interests of what they want to hold up as achievement. And so you have, you know, a gigantic split in the universe from Twin Galaxies' perspective because it held very firm to a very specific set of rules. And it wouldn't change them or add, be more inclusive. So there's give and take on both ends. And look, nothing's ever going to be perfect, you know? Like, it's like, all I can do is, you know, the best thing that I think that should be done, and I always have this big picture in my head, right? And because I don't have a particular agenda regard to anybody on the site, none. Everybody's a community member. Everybody has a voice. That, to me, that's, there you go. I'm just trying to create an environment that is as conducive as possible to growth and to support all the concerns. That's not an easy thing to do. And prior to, I'm telling you, every owner before me has had a huge challenge in this area. And in my personal view, Don says, I guess it's the difference between a few people I rate about the rules versus an across the internet all out war. Yeah, you know, that's the thing, that's true. But man, I'm so old and crusty, I can tell you, it's a few people who are irate about the rules can become an across the internet all out war. I've seen it happen. It's, you know, so I, you know, it's either people want Twin Galaxies to be welcoming and supportive and inclusive of all the different kinds of ways people like to game and like to sort of rate themselves, right? Either you want that, or people want Twin Galaxies to be more of this sort of exclusive, limited edition type club for the few. Right, and you can structure your philosophies and sort of rule directions in a percentage way in either direction. The current ownership wants Twin Galaxies to be as accessible and as interesting to as many people as possible. I think that's the healthiest form of it, because when I've done extensive research on Twin Galaxies' past. I've seen other methodologies used, and you know, in a lot of times, Twin Galaxies, literally through its own policies, choked itself off. And I don't want us to do that again. I don't want us to do it. I mean, if we're going to die, we're going to die in a whole brand new, different fashion. It'll be a spectacular explosion instead of like, you know, like a snuff out of the light. You know, you snuff the light out or something. It'll be, who knows? All right, let's keep going. Because I'm taking too long. Holy crap. I only have 5 minutes left. Holy crap. All right. Let's see. What is this? I'll go. This is pretty late. I don't know if we'll see it in time. This is a question of how do we get a track changed that needs its rule change to select. He needs a track naming change. That's an email you would send to Franny. Hugged. I think Hugged asked this question. You'd send that to Franny at twingalaxies.com, and then we can see. Will another version of Elite Lounge Live ever return? I'm not sure, Scarlet Speedster. What's up, Evil Joker Gaming? Where's Walter Day? He's in Iowa. Okay, now this is real quick. Speed run timings, okay? This has been brought up to me by many different people. In the historic Twin Galaxies, they had a simple policy. They didn't accept any fractional seconds for time-based submissions on titles that don't have a built-in timer, okay? Right now, we're getting people who are submitting speedruns with fractional times, and there's no built-in timer on these games, and that's creating adjudication problems. So one of the things that we are having to consider is maybe making whole seconds for anything that doesn't have a built-in timer, making whole seconds the thing until we come up with a better timer solution. So that's something we should talk about on the forums, but just know that that's something that's being bantered about, because we do want to have adjudications make sense, and it is very difficult for individual adjudicators to get down to the same thousandth of a second when they're looking at the video performance. I hope that made sense. Okay, we have a cancel feature, which we're discussing now on the forums. I think what it's going to turn into is a sort of a self-reject flag that informs everybody and just sort of leaves it at that for the most part. I think that's where we're landing so far, but the conversation is still continuing. And I missed the classic leaderboard with the asteroids and Galaga in space in the background. Yeah, that's been archived. So really quick, since I have 2 minutes left, blogs are going to become more and more important. We're going to be shifting our feeds. So when you log in, you know, you see your news feed. That news feed is only going to be composed of other members of Twin Galaxies that you have decided to follow, because we're going to add a follow button, or friends with. So that way, everybody can keep up with each other, and you don't get extra nonsense in your feed. So your blog, and so then what will happen is the more followers that you get to your particular blog, right, the more we'll be able to actually provide value for that. Because if you're taking the time, let's say you're just writing a blog about, you know, reconstructing arcade machines, right? And you're posting, and a lot of people start subscribing to that. We want to build in a mechanism that either allows people to start to earn from that, whether that be internal commerce of Twin Galaxies or even external commerce. So in any case, it's a lot of work for us to do, but your news feed will be just those updates of the people that you've decided to subscribe to, their latest updates. It's kind of like Facebook, right? And your updates will go to all of your friends. And it'll be a way to do that. I'm at 10 seconds, so I gotta go. The shotgun challenge is over. You'll see that in Twin Galaxies. I gotta go. I'm out. Bye. Oh my God.